Sometimes you look up into the night sky and see something amazing passing by. Brighter and closer than any star, traveling our solar system from very far. A nucleus made from frozen gas, rock, and ice. Tails streaming behind them that look so nice. What are these bright visitors in the sky? Where did they come from, how, and why?
They are comets, travelers way up high. Cosmic snowballs that pass us by.
I'm Comet Bennett, C1969Y1. I take almost 1,750 years to orbit the sun. Found by an astronomer in South Africa in 1969. By early 1970, I could be seen by the unaided eye. My ion tail has filaments like sparkling thread. And I have multiple anti-tails shooting out of my head. The anti-tails are just dust trails left behind. Interactions with my ion tail and solar winds make these filaments of mine. Ikeya-Seki, I visited in 1965. I could be seen in the daytime. I shone so bright. Discovered by two Japanese astronomers at almost the same time. I take about 878 years to complete one orbit of mine. A Sungrazer comet I passed extremely close to the sun and broke into three pieces just before I reached perihelion. Two of the three pieces will return on their own comet journeys. Around 2842 and 3021 is when that will be. Discovered by a Czech astronomer in March 1973, I'm Comet Kohoutek, and people had very high hopes for me. It was my first trip to the inner solar system from the Oort cloud. Would I be the comet of the century and make everyone proud? Unfortunately, I didn't put on a very good show, except for some astronauts in space looking down at Earth below. I feel bad because I come from so far away, I fear I won't get another chance to impress for 75,000 years.
Comets, our journey is so much fun as we slingshot around the sun.
Doesn't matter where you are, if you're amateur or professional, astronomers make discoveries from all around the world. Some observe the sky from their very own backyard. Others use powerful telescopes and facilities to watch the stars. Some comets prefer a safe and cautious track. These are periodic comets that keep coming back. Other daredevil comets like to see how close they can get to the sun. Sungrazer comets that either crash, disintegrate, or break up and continue on.
Comets, travelers, way up high. Cosmic snow.
Pons-Brooks, discovered by French astronomers. A short period comet, I orbit the sun every 71 years. I have outbursts of gas and dust that made me look like I have horns on me. I caused the Capitol Conus meteor shower in December, you'll see.
The Great Comet of 1861, that's when I passed by, first spotted by a farmer, a fuzzy object in the Australian sky. Earth passed through my tail, which created a spectacular sight. As bright as Venus, my tail streaked across the night.
I'm Comet C2024L5 Atlas. I was traveling through the solar system, minding my own business. When I approached planet Saturn, I was in for a surprise. I got caught in Saturn's momentum in 2022 when passing by. The new momentum broke my original orbit around the sun, and Saturn flung me off course and out of the solar system. This isn't the first time a planet thought throwing comets would be fun. In 1980, Jupiter did the same to Comet C1980E1.
Discovered in Chile, the Great Comet of 2025. I was a spectacular apparition in the night sky. My awesomeness could also be seen in daylight, nice and clear. A long period comet I won't visit again for 160,000 years.
I'm weirdo Comet 29B Schwassmann-Wachmann 1. Hi, erupting with unpredictable bright outbursts. Nobody knows why. I'm a centaur orbiting between Saturn and Jupiter, you know, the second most active object in the solar system next to Jupiter's moon Io.
Long ago, a very large, long-period comet approached the sun. It came very close to the sun at its perihelion. It was the comet that inspired Sungrazer classification and was broken apart by tidal forces and solar radiation.
The result was the creation of the Kreutz Sungrazer family, daredevil comets that continue to travel close to the sun, you see.
Some of them even dive into the sun's core on our